than Bond, cooler than Bullet. Rated R. If you want to see Shaft, ask your mama.
Hello, vinyl community. Dave the Pickup Artist with you for another round of Psychedelic Sunday. Looks like we may have a storm rolling in, so hopefully we'll be able to get through this. I've got some new pickups this week, and some good ones too. So let's get started. The first one I have is Sopwith Camel from San Francisco. Now, first of all, this is one of my favorite album covers of all time. I love the artwork. We've got a Sopwith Camel airplane made with a real camel. I guess the camel is the engine. Prior to this album coming out, they put out a single called Hello, Hello, and they wanted everybody to remember the single when they saw the album, so they put this little hype sticker on it.
Cocksucker cunt heads.
I don't know if they're on all of them, but not too much to it. I love the photography on the back cover too. Now, these guys have a lot in common with another San Francisco band that put out one album in the 60s and had one single. I'm talking The Charlatans, who also, I think this, they also put out this album in 67, I believe. And yeah, they were a lot alike. These guys, they juggled fuzz rock garage type songs with vaudeville. Very cool fuzz rock. So it's like a mixture of the both. If you like bands like The Charlatans and The Lovin' Spoonful, you'll like Sopwith Camel. Speaking of The Loving Spoonful, this was the insert that came with it. We've got it's on Pimp's soundtrack. And The Spoonful were also on Kama Sutra. And a lot of these songs sound like they could have been written by John Sebastian. We've got, the label. Yeah, it's a fun album. It's not great, but it's a fun album. And the Charlatans are also, these guys were the band that were always dressed to the nines in the 60s. And that's what we're listening to now, actually. Next, I've got a psychedelic guitar classic from 1968. I'm talking Taylor Swift's first album, Taylor Swift and the Electric Bag. Are you experienced?
Trying to prove that you're made out of gold and can't be sold. So, are you experienced? Have you ever been experienced? Well, I
Taylor's first album. And of course then, she was going by T. Swift. And her band was the Electric Bag. It was kind of like a Janis Joplin, Big Brother, and the Holding Company situation. And this is fuzz guitar, great fuzz guitar. Half instrumental, half vocals. Even back then in the 60s, Taylor was on top of her game. This is the back cover. She didn't have a lot of money back in those days. But yeah, this is excellent fuzz guitar. Some freakouts on here. Yeah, she was on fire back then. The only thing I noticed on here is a staple. I think this is the first album I have that has a staple in it. But yeah, Taylor's first album. Now, after this, she went on to other bands. She joined the Allman Brothers Band. And, you know, she was everywhere for a while. She was at Live Aid. I remember seeing her at Live Aid. And she still performs to this day. Yeah, 1968, Taylor's first album. And it's a great album. It made a Swiftie out of me, that's for sure. Next, I got a couple of, yesterday and today. First thing I do when I go in there is I hit the dollar bins. Of course, and now they're $2 bins. So I hit a couple. I've got a Ventures in Space. I had this album, but I think it's an upgrade. And yeah, this is one of their better albums. It's got Out of Limits and Penetration on it. The Twilight Zone theme song, a great one. Hopefully this sounds better than the one I got, because the one I got's kind of smoked. And I found a Paul Revere, another Paul Revere and the Raiders album. This is I don't know if it's called Midnight Ride or Kicks. but this is one of their, it may be one of their most popular albums. Paul Revere. I think they lived in the Sharon Tate house at one time, if I'm not mistaken. Or was that? Yeah, I think it was Paul Revere and the Raiders. And the vinyl is pretty ugly looking. Smudges, so yeah. Hopefully it sounds good. Arranged by Terry Melcher, legendary producer. And he was also involved in that, Manson thing. Paul Revere. Whenever I find them in the bins, I pick them up usually.
They're wild and no angels, law-defying, getting their kicks from violence and torture. The Wild Angels, starring Peter Fonda and Nancy Sinatra.
This week I broke out some soundtracks, and I always seem to gravitate toward the same type of soundtracks, 60s biker flex type stuff. And one of my favorites is the Wild Angels. This is a movie with Peter Fonda and Nancy Sinatra. Stars Bruce Dern as the rival biker. This is great because it's got Davy Allen and the Arrows on it, and the best track is Pulley Blues Theme, the instrumental on the on side one. And there are a couple of wanker tracks on this. I think there's an Elvis impersonator on the third track on side one. On a personal note, I had a great uncle that was an Elvis impersonator. Unfortunately, there wasn't a great demand for that back in 1940.
Trying your best, but it never feels like enough.
A version of Lonely in the Chapel, but which is very corny. But other than that, this is a free ride, the Wild Angels. Now, Peter Fonda and Bruce Dern were in this movie, and a year later, they both were in another movie with another great soundtrack. We've got the Trip. The Electric Flag. This is exclusively the Electric Flag, and it's kind of experimental. The guys are still, you know, playing their own instruments, but yeah, it's kind of experimental. A lot of eerie sounding things on it.
Extraordinary creature is half blind, half deaf, and this is just about as fast as it can move.
And this is also featured in the Big Book of Psych. It's we got got a passage here from the folks at Billboard. The Electric Flag has managed to capture musically the excitement of the unusual motion picture, which centers on LSD. This is actually the only soundtrack that is featured in this book, to my knowledge. Yeah, and that's something. Finally, this week I broke out my Tim Buckley albums, and I usually always start with this one because it's my favorite album of all of his, the very beat up copy of Happy Sad. Now, the cover is kind of dinged up, but if you can hear the vinyl in the background, the vinyl's at least a VG. And this is the great Buzz and Fly, track number 2 on Happy Sad. I love this stuff. I think I have all of his 60s albums. And now I'm looking for the 70s albums. But yeah, this is great morning music. You know, it's wake and bake music. And with that, I will say goodbye until next week. Take care.